and get ourselves hooked up. Today for our workout, we're going to be doing a circuit. So instead of going through our exercises back to back, we're going to go through one round. We're going to do a little bit of cardio, and then we're going to go through those same exercises one more time. So we're still doing two reps. We're just doing them in a slightly different order than we normally do. So let's go ahead and take a sip of water. If you've not already done so, I'm going to go ahead and get our Instagram started and we'll get going. All right, cool. Awesome, got the Instagram going. Everyone come up to stand if you're not already up. Start by just shrugging the shoulders out. I'm actually gonna demonstrate the exercises that we're gonna do. So for our upper body circuit, we're gonna do them twice. And for the lower body circuit, we're gonna do them three times. So for the upper body circuit, we're familiar with these, we've done them before. It's wrist curl, an overhead tricep push-up. So I'm gonna come down, my hips are up, I take my gaze between my feet, I go down and up. The next move is a bicep curl. Then we have a push-up, obviously on my hands, we know how to do those. And lastly, forearm plank hip dip. So I come into my forearm plank and I dip side to side. So those are our five moves. Let's go ahead and reach across the body a couple times, open up the spine. And the interval today for the time is gonna be 45 seconds. So it's not as bad as a full minute, but we are gonna go through it a few times. Okay, keep reaching, twisting. Get your cycle going if you have not already done so. And let's go ahead and get started with our first move of the day, which is a wrist curl. So I bring my hands down by my sides, I make fists and I curl up and up. We've got 45 seconds, time is rolling now. Jump on in when you're ready. And so the nice thing about doing a circuit with moves that are familiar is that we can start to move a little bit faster because we're comfortable with what we're doing. And if these moves are still fairly new to you or your body's still building the strength to do them, take it as slow as you need to. We get to pick our pace. We're doing time, not number of reps. We have the ability to pick how fast or slow we want to go. Good, half done. Good. And we can make these hard, pretending like we're holding really big weights and trying not to bend the elbows as much as we can. Up and up. Good. Last 10. We have 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So we did those. Let's come on down for our next exercise. It's an overhead tricep push-up. So I press my hips up and back. I tuck my chin into my chest, looking back between my feet.
And let's do that overhead push-up. Mm-hmm. And you might not have as much range of motion on these as you would a normal push-up, and that's okay. We're working the triceps, little baby muscles, so they're especially hard. And if you need to take a bend in your knees to get your hips a little bit higher, that's cool. Down and up. Nice. All right, last 10. Then we're gonna come up for bicep curls in 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, two and one. Come on up to stands. Glue the elbows into the midline of the body. Grab your imaginary weights. Let's pick up imaginary light weights and we're gonna go fast. 45 seconds, here we go. Up, up, up. Incredibly safe maneuver. We're holding no weight, we're just pretending to. We're using those bands to utilize our body weight and really big strength, build strength. Up, up, nice. It's a little different when we jump from one move to the next. But don't you worry, we got a whole nother set of these. Awesome. 20 more seconds. Lift, lift, squeeze those bands. Pop them off your arms, you're squeezing so hard. Yes, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, three, two, and one. Next up, we come back down onto our hands and knees. You can either do your push-ups on your knees or you can step your feet back. 45 seconds push-ups in four, three, two, and one. Drop it down, press back up. Now I want your form to be impeccable. So that means nice straight spine, flat back, squeezing your hips, your glutes, your core the whole time to support your back. Nice, Quinn, good. Awesome. I like it. Half done. Ooh, that's a staff. Last 10. Keep going, keep going. Come on, Gabe. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and rest. Good job. We're going to stay on our hands and knees. Give your wrists a twirl, a circle, release them. Other side. And then we'll make our way down to our forearms. So it's a regular forearm plank. And keeping the shoulders stable, we start to rock our hips side to side. In an ideal world, you get your hips to touch the floor, but for the sake of this exercise and stability, you're working towards the floor as far as you can go. Time is rolling, here we go. Alternative modification, if you should need, drop your knees and just rock side to side here. Still working the forearms, still working the shoulders, keeping the upper body stable. And we're also working our obliques, sides of our abs here. Cool. Nice, Lily. Got a crew, got a good crew. Last 10. Woo, good. Upper body is stable and strong for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hop on up to stand. We're going to get our heart rate up, and then we're going to go through that again. Our heart rate moves for today are lateral high knees. So I get my knees up, and I'm going side to side. After that, it's a punch jack. And after that, pendulum kick, swing, swing, up, swing, swing, up. 30 seconds of each. We're gonna start with those lateral high knees in four, three, two, and one. 30 seconds, get them up, moving side to side. Good. If you want an extra challenge, you can reach your arms straight up as you do it. Not for the sake of pulling blood in our arms because they're up and overhead, but just for the sake of making the move a little bit more challenging. Get those knees up. Yeah, there we go. Last 10, and we're coming in punch jacks. In 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Punch jacks, here we go. Punch it out. Woo, let me see some speedy feet. Now we're talking. Yeah. Half done. After this, we have pendulum kicks, which is one of my favorites. I love side kicks. In 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Arms out. Here we go. Swing, swing, up. Swing, swing, up. Keep going side to side. Good. Keep those arms straight and strong. Ooh, a little bit faster. Last 10, give me all you got. We have 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Catch your breath, 30 seconds rest. Grab water if you want it. We're gonna do it all again. Ooh, and we just did all the moves, so we know we can. And now, as we're getting more comfortable with those movements, we can start to add more speed, should we feel it's appropriate. All right. We'll all meet standing, wrist curls, bring the elbows in, make those fists in 3, 2, 1, 45 seconds, lift, squeeze and squeeze, getting into the forearms, baby muscles, I was watching, this is what I do in my free time. I was watching YouTube videos of American Ninja Warrior last night, and I was so inspired. I was like, gosh, those guys and girls can control their body weight so well. If you've never watched American Ninja Warrior, take like 5 minutes of your life and YouTube it. It's pretty great. Last 10. You do these like obstacle courses and they're just flinging their bodies around. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We have 20 seconds to make our way down onto the mat. Lift your hips up and back behind you. Set yourself up. We're going in 5, 4, 3, and 2. Drop down, press up. Drop down, press up. Keep it going. And there's a temptation here to try and look down at the floor. Do your best not to look down at the floor. So look back between your feet so that you're leading with the very top of your head. Cool, Bonnie, good. Awesome, and as you do this, keep pressing your hips up and back even more, even more. You're getting a secret hamstring stretch in there. These look great, yeah. Last 15 seconds. Ooh, Diane's got it, good. Give me 4 more, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Come on, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hop on up, 20 seconds to make your way up. We're gonna give the wrists a rest with some bicep curls. Glue the elbows in, make fists, grab your imaginary weights. You can go fast or you can go slow, play with it, but I do not want you to fully lock your arms out, so always keep a bend. Here we go, 45 seconds, up. Up, squeeze, squeeze. And the whole time I'm doing this, I'm also pulling my arms in towards the midline of my body. Pump, pump, yeah. So we don't want rogue limbs, we want strong limbs, control. That's it. Good. Pump it, mm-hmm, half done. Add a little speed if you're feeling good, you're up, up. Last round of the day. We have 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. 20 seconds. Make your way back down onto the floor. 2 more moves to do here. We're going to get our heart rate up, and then we're going to move on to the legs. So go ahead and walk yourself back into plank if you're taking your push-ups in plank today. 4 to 5 seconds. Here we go. Drop it down. Press up. Down, up. Now, for these ones, if your knees are off the floor, I don't care how fast you're going, and I don't care how many you're doing. I would like to see you try and keep your knees up the whole time. So even if that means little pauses in plank, if you've committed to being in plank, try and make it happen. Push yourselves. We're strong enough to do this. Good, half done. Nice. Tie, these look amazing. Go, Kayleen, go. Cool. Last 15. Mm-hmm. We have 10, 9, 3 more, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Everybody drop your knees, give your left wrist a roll. Give your right wrist a roll. Make your way down onto your forearms. You can either keep your knees on the floor or come up into a forearm plank. Come on up, 45 seconds, rock it side to side. Hip dips in forearm plank. And my shoulders here are not moving, only the rest of my body. My arms stay really stable, even as I'm rocking my body side to side. Keep going. Great. Zoom looks good. If you're joining Instagram now, jump into that forearm plank and get the hips going side to side. Yes, last 15. Keep breathing. We have 8, 7, 6, add some speed, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hop on up, 20 seconds. We're getting a heart rate up again. Then we're going to swap out our bands and have our question of the day. If there's anyone on here who I have not met yet, looks like there might be one or two people. My name is Laurel. Welcome to our weekday workout. We sweat, we grow stronger, we laugh, we share things about ourselves, and we have a good time. All right, 30 seconds, lateral high knees. 3, 2, 1, here we go, get them up. Nice. Higher knees. Now, something to be mindful of as you're doing this. Your spine is not rounding out. Straight spine. Get those knees up, up, up. That's the stuff. 12. 8. Last 6. 5, 4, 3, 2. Hop out. Hop back. Punch jacks. Pick up that pace. There we go. Half done. Woo, want to see some speed. Get those arms going. 10, 9, 8, 7. Pendulum kicks in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hop back. Arms out. Here we go. Swing, swing, up. Swing, swing, up. Keep going. I love it. Pick up the pace. Here we go. Last 10. We have 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo, good job. Grab a sip of water. Swap out your bands. If there's anyone new to class, feel free to ask any questions you might have now, either by unmuting or tossing them in the chat. The question of the day is, are you a sweet person or a salty person, if you had to choose your taste profile? And depending on what you choose, what is your favorite either sweet or salty food? Let me hear what you got as we're swapping out our bands. I'll start. I'm a salty person, and my favorite salty food, anything crunchy or just a good burrito. I'm gonna go burrito. What do we got?
Salt and crunch.
What was that?
Salt and crunch.
Salt and crunch. I like it. We're on the same page with that one.
So it'll have to be sweets and chocolate of
sweet.
Some sort.
I get it. I am a big chocolate fan as well, so I understand that one. Quentin says sweet and candy. And it looks like my AirPods stopped working, so I'll just take these out. If you guys can't hear me, just like wave your hand, say no. What else? Sweet and candy. Any candy in particular? Just like all candy. John says salty, chips, salsa, and coconut, perhaps for Steve. All right, what else we got? Sweet tooth, cake and pie, says Sydney. I have to say, if I were to pick my favorite sweet thing, it would definitely be pie. Ty says salty and chips. Yeah, the crunchy stuff. Kayleen says sweet and ice cream. All right, I like it. Steve says sweet ice cream, chocolate ice cream with coconut shavings. Oh, this is all making me hungry. All right. Sorry if there's any background noise, guys. My headphones decided to take a nap, so I'm gonna let them sleep and we'll continue on with our workout. Quentin says, also on a side note, I love American Ninja Warrior and used to go to a gym near my house every weekend. I just found out that there are American Ninja Warrior gyms and I'm so excited once they open up back again. Kayleen, this is Kayleen's sister. Hi, Kayleen's sister. Cool. All right, now I see your face. I just saw like a body moving and I was like, that could be cute, yeah. All right, let's hop on up, guys. For our lower body circuit, we're gonna go through this one 3 times. The moves I'm gonna demonstrate and then we'll go through our circuit. So the first move is just a nice heel lift up and down. If you want to play with the heel lift and do single leg, or whatever that might be, you can go for that. Our second move is squat, reach, jump. So I reach down, down, down. If jumping's not happening for you today, you can step, step. Our third move is pendulum lunges. So we're gonna do one side at a time. I start with my left leg, I lunge back, lunge forward, lunge back, lunge forward. And we'll do half of each side. Our next move is the half burpee surfer. I come back into plank. I jump up, surf, hands down, jump back. Jump up, surf, hands down, jump back. After that, we have a sumo reach up and down. I go down, up, down, and up. And I'll review all of these with you guys once we get going. And we have a heart rate boost in there. Someone shared something on the chat. My grandnephew and his fifth birthday party. And I just now am learning about these gyms. I'm so excited. Thank you, George. And Quentin, I'm learning about all these new things. All right, so let's start with some hip circles to open everything up before we get going. See, like five-year-olds are going to these gyms, everyone's going to these gyms, and I'm over here just like, how do I become a ninja? And other way. I feel like this is something this group would enjoy doing. If not participating, at least watching, because we're all really into fitness and moving our bodies. All right, so heel toe the feet, hips distance apart. 45 seconds, heel lifts, we're going, work into it. Up and down. Good. If you wanna play, yesterday we did bicycle, you can do bicycle instead. Or you can just do straight up and down, either way. And I did bicycle yesterday, so I'm just gonna do regular heel lifts for this set. Sweet. I need to Google American Ninja Warrior gyms in LA. I'm sure there has to be one. Nice, last 15. See if you can do these without letting your heels touch the floor. So I hover, up, mm-hmm. Last 7, 6, 5, 4. 3, 2, and 1. Squat, reach, jump. Step the feet wide. I reach down. We're gonna go in 3, 2, and 1. I reach, jump in, reach. In, out, that's a step. And as you're doing this, I'm not slouching, I'm dropping my butt down to get lower and lower. I don't actually care if you touch the floor. Just try and keep dropping your butt lower and lower into the squat.
Cool.
Good. Kayleen's sister, I'm gonna have to get your name at some point so I can actually refer to you by name. Nice, Indian Sophia, good. Girls who also like pie, Diane, amazing. Woo, here we go. Give me everything you got, last 10. Mm-hmm. We have 8. Yeah, Bonnie, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Cool. So let's rotate sideways. We're gonna do pendulum lunges. We're gonna do 30 seconds per side. So if we do less than 30 seconds, it's just a lot of like scrambling around. So let's start with the left leg. Lunge back. You can either tap or hover. Lunge forward, time's going. Lunge back, tap or hover, lunge forward. Keep it up. Good. Nice balance. Fantastic. John and Chris, I can't see, but I know you're doing the best pendulum lunges you've ever done in your life. Awesome, George. Good, we're gonna switch sides in 4, 3, 2, and 1. Right leg, lunge it back. Either step or hover, Lunge forward. Come center, back, come center, forward.
Jim, cool. I'm glad you stuck with it. You got it. Oh, these are so great. I'm seeing some hovers in between, and I like it. We're working the balance. Last 10. Mm-hmm. Good. We're going to go into the half burpee surfers in 5, 4, 3, and 2. Drop down your hands and knees to start. All right. So let's set up in a good plank. Step the feet back. You can either step or hop up. Feet come to meet hands. I'm going to go ahead and start my time now. So we either step or jump up. Come into that serve. Hands come down. Hop back. Hop up. Serve other way. Hands down. Hop back. You can also step. Serve. Hands down. Step back. Either way.
Yes. I see those hands. I see those surfers. Those of you who don't live in California should come visit California. You're perfectly primed. Good. Keep going, keep going. Half done. Yes. 10 more seconds. See if you can give me 3 more. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Everybody come on up to stand. Catch your breath. I know that was a lot. Okay, we've got 15 seconds to rest. We're gonna start to make our way into a wide-legged stance for our sumo squat reach. So in a sumo squat, I wanna angle my toes out as far towards the side walls as I can. I'm going to reach my arms up. And time is rolling. I drop down as low as I can. Rise, down, up. You can make these fast if you really need to. You can jump.
No jumpers today? Okay, fine. Woo! I see arms flying. Also on these ones, making sure that even if we drop down into it, we don't round down into it. We sink our butt down. Reach, down, up. There we go. Nice. 15 more seconds. See if you can add a little bit of speed as you sink your butt lower and lower. Last 10. Let me see, 4 more. 8, 7, 6, 5. We're moving. 4, 3, 2, and 1.
Come on up to stand. Make your way over to one side of your workspace. 30 seconds. Lateral high knees. Then we're going to take a break after this boost. Here we go. Get those knees up. Higher, higher, higher. Yeah. Nice. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hop wide, punch jacks. Quick feet, quick feet. There we go, last 10. Give me everything you got, then we're doing pendulum kicks. In 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and hop wide. We're moving. Swing, swing, up. Swing, swing, up. Cool. All right, keep going. Last 10. We have 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Whew.
All right. Now I get to do it again. And based on time, I think we'll probably have time to do it once more. So operating under the fact that we're gonna do this one more time, let's give it everything we've got. Really work it hard.
And then after this, we're gonna work on some standing balance, some core, and we'll wrap it up. Okay, so take your minute of rest. We're already 30 seconds in. Grab water, walk around, move, breathe. Cool.
Can you guys give me a thumbs up if you can hear me? Yeah, okay. My AirPods decided to wake up again. I don't know, they haven't minded their end. All right, let's come on up. So we're starting off fairly quote unquote easy with our heel lifts. So you can either do regular heel lifts or you can do the bicycle. But whichever variation you're doing, I want your shoulders to stay stacked over your hips. So no rounding out, no swaying out to compensate as you do this. We're only working into the back of the legs. So let's take our 45 seconds. Everyone get your heels up. Start to move through it, either bicycles or just up and down. Whichever one you're doing, do your best not to let your heels touch the floor. Yeah. We want to keep growing taller and taller from the top of our head. And this is one of those moves where if you find a spot on the wall or the floor to look at, to kind of focus on, it can help you with balance and you can maybe work faster. Ooh. All right. Last 10. Get those heels going. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now, let's start to move fast. Step the feet slightly wider than hip distance. They are angled out a little bit, but not that much. So ever so slight external rotation, squat, reach, jump. On your mark, get set, here we go. Reach down, jump, jump. Yeah, I love it. Good job, keep going. Nice, making sure that we keep our spine, you know what I'm gonna say, straight as we hop into it. Half done. Last round of the day, we can do this. After this, we get to slow the heart rate down a little bit with our pendulum lunges. We're working more on balance. Yes. 15 more seconds. Ooh, get your butt even lower. Uh-huh. All right, I wanna see 5 more, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Ty, killed it, awesome, good job. Okay, shake it out, kick it out. Pendulum lunges, starting with the right leg. Step your feet parallel, bring the right leg back behind you into reverse lunge, 45 seconds. We hover or step it up, come forward, up, come back. Time is rolling. We're doing 30 seconds per side. And for this one, think bodily control instead of speed. So how low can you drop that back knee towards the floor? And can you hover the foot off the floor as you come back to your center? Yes. Good. In 5, we're going to work into the left leg. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Step the left foot back. Time is rolling. We hover it up. Lunge forward. Hover it up. Lunge back. Hover. Lunge. Hover. And lunge. Keep going. And that's my speed. It's pretty fast. Feel free to go slower. If you can control your body and go faster, go for it. Just as much core as anything else. Half done. Yeah. And last 7, 6, 5, 4, three, two, and one. Let's release that before we move on to our next exercise. Hands across the shoulders. Glue the elbows in towards the body. Six good mornings. Hinge forward, flat back. Squeeze your glutes, come forward. Hinge forward, flat back. Squeeze to lift. Four more. Opening up the backs of the legs. Two. And one. All right. Half burpee surfers. We come down to the floor. Good. I jump up, surf. Hand down, jump back, other side. On your marks, get set, go for it. Now these ones, we wanna get the heart rate going. So I wanna see you move as fast as you comfortably can. And we're not doing intermittent intervals today, so it's a little bit easier than some circuits we've done. This allows us to build speed. Good, on that surf, jump into it, get your butt low, bring hands down, jump back. So make it easier to get your hands down to the floor by jumping really low as you surf, keeping your body weight low to your mat, AKA your surfboard. Woo! There we go. Yes, amazing. 20 more seconds. Oh my goodness, we're going all out. After this, we get to do our sumo reach so we can let the heart rate slow down a little bit. We have 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, five, one more, four, three, two, and one. Come on up to stand. Fantastic job. All right, step the feet wide. Angle the toes out. Sumo reach. Now, technically, if we really wanted to squeeze, we could have time to do one more round of these exercises, but we're gonna call it here. So because we're calling it here, I wanna see this be the most powerful variation this exercise can possibly be for your body. So if that means you have it in you to give me a jump at the top, I wanna see you jump. If that means that you even do the whole exercise for 45 seconds without stopping, whatever it looks like, we're going in three, two, one. I go down, up. We are going. Woo! Oh my goodness, I see some leaps. I see movement. I see everyone moving, and that's all I care about. Sydney looks good. Yes. Woo, keep going. Sixteen, 15, 14, 13. 12, 11, go Gabe, 10, 9, 8, 7, quit and go, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, 20 seconds rest. We get our heart rate up one more time. I know we're tired. We did so great. Seriously, I saw arms flying. I saw bodies moving. That was the spirit of exactly what I wanted to see. All right. Make your way onto one side of your workspace. We've got 30 seconds to get our heart rate up, and then everything we do for the rest of the session is gonna slow everything down. So, lateral high knees in three, two, one. Here we go, get them up side to side. Yeah. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and jump wide. Punch jacks. Let's go. That's it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Jump wide. Pendulum kicks. Get that leg all the way out there. There we go. Yes, a little bit of speed, a little bit of speed. Let's go all in. 15. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Oh, good job. All right. Grab some water, shrug the shoulders out, catch your breath. Heart rate is soaring right now, and that's what we want. All right, balance. So we practice those pendulum kicks, getting our legs out to the sides. Let's work into that just a little bit. We're gonna do what I call a standing side series. We're only doing one type of movement per leg, and it's out to the side. So we'll go through one set, we'll do the other leg, and we'll come down for core. So we can push ourselves. All right, bring your arms up to your sides. We're gonna work the left leg to start to hover that foot off the floor. You can also tap your big toe down. I want you to start little kicks up and up. Notice that the right side of my body stays straight. We're gonna lift for 10, then we're gonna hold for 10. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, higher, 3, 2, lift and hold it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and rest. Right into the right leg, up and up. 10, 9, 8, 7. I see some people falling. It's okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, lift and hold it. 10, 9, 8, 7. Squeeze. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We did it. 3 core moves. X crunch, fingers to toes, hollow body hold. My X crunch, I roll up, I reach right fingertips to left toes, I come down, making an X shape. I roll up, left fingertips to right toes, I come back down. 30 seconds in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. I roll up and back. Try and get your whole spine off the floor or as much of it as you can. Good. And we're doing our core like a circuit today as well. So we're gonna go through these moves, 3 of them, 2 times. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Legs up, fingers to toes, crunch it. 10 is rolling, up, up. See if you can find contact. There we go. Our last move after this one, I think, is the hardest one for the core. Half done. See if you can keep your head off the floor the whole time. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now this next move, as long as your back, your spine is rooted into the floor, that's all that matters here. I extend my legs out, my arms come back, I lift my head off the floor, hollow body hold, 30 seconds. Press your spine down. If your spine is not rooted into the floor, don't drop your legs as low. If you want more of a challenge, reach your arms back further, drop your legs even lower, half done. And breathe. Good. Last 10, pull the belly button in towards the spine. In 5, we're gonna pull the knees into the chest. 4, 3, 2, and rest, rock side to side. Now we have one more round of that. Extend your legs long, reach your arms back behind you. 30 seconds, X crunch, re-roll up, tap the toes, come back down, up. Tap and roll. Everybody's doing great. I like it. Last 6, 5, 4, killer bunny. 3, 2, and 1. Extend your legs straight up, fingers to toes. Reach, reach. Reach, time's rolling. After this, we have one more thing. It's our hollow body hold. I know. Awesome, Quentin. Keep going. Good tie. Go, Lily. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Everyone pull your knees into your chest. We're going to do our hollow body hold together. So let's set ourselves up. Extend your legs out. Reach your arms back behind you. 30 seconds. We are going. Nice. Woo, core is shaking, legs are shaking. Try and drop your arms alongside your ears. Reach your heels and your fingertips in opposite directions. 13, 12, 11. Press your spine down for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and rest. Pull the knees into the chest. All right. Start to rock and roll up and down along the spine until you come up to sit. If you want to take your bands off now, you can. When we do a workout with our bands on, it is encouraged to stretch without them. So we're going to pop our bands off. We're going to stretch for about 3 minutes, and then I'll send you on your way. Go ahead and take the bands off. Take the sole of the right foot into the left leg. Reach both arms up, rotate over to the left, drop the hands down, framing the leg, letting your forehead and your belly button drop towards the left side. You're going to shake the head, yes. And we're going to be here for 30 seconds. In order for any stretch to actually be effective, you have to hold it for a minimum of 15 seconds. But we're good, we're strong, so we're going to double that. And this is where we get to let the body slow down. We breathe, we release. We did a lot of contracting in the muscles. It's important that we can keep growing stronger and we don't completely lock up, that we also stretch these things out. Last 10. One more big breath. Good, roll up to sit, switch legs, sole the left foot into the right leg. I'm stretching the hamstring as well as my inner thigh muscle, the adductor. Reach the arms up. Rotate over to the right, drop your forehead and your belly button towards the right thigh. We got our 30 second hold. Using the weight of the upper body to help me stretch. Nice, good, shake your head no. Last 10 seconds. One more big breath. And roll up to sit. Take the soles of feet together. Last stretch here. Give the knees a flutter. Reach the arms up. Fold forward. Root them into the floor wherever that might be. Maybe you're grabbing onto your toes. And let the upper body completely round and hang. Our last 30 seconds here. Letting the heads of the shoulders fall towards the floor. And last 10 seconds. And when you're ready, slowly start to roll up to sit. Reach the arms up, clasp the hands, press the base of the palms away from the body, shoulder stretch. And release them, give yourself a round, leg hold round. Good job, circuit day, hard. Awesome job, everybody.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome, I'll see you tomorrow.
Take care, bye.
Thank you. Thank you.